is Luv Johar. Thanks to all of you who have subscribed to my channel and thanks for watching my videos. So in this particular training video, we will try to understand how do we initiate the implementation of ISO 27001 for any organization. So let's say that you are a company who is trying to help your clients achieve ISO 27001 certification and become ISO 27001 certified. Or let's say if you are an internal employee within your organization and you want to implement ISO 27001 within your organization, so you must be thinking, where should I start from? So in this particular video, we will actually give you the basic starting point for how to begin this exercise of ISO 27001 implementation. So an important note before I begin this particular training video, that I'm already assuming that by now you must have the latest ISO 27001 standard with you. If not, then you must have purchased it by now, and you must be familiar with the standard a little bit, so that you know it will help you during this implementation. If you don't have the standard, then you would not be able to implement ISO 27001 completely within your organization, because you have to go as per the standard, as per the requirements which are there in the ISO 27001. So if you don't have the standard by now, I would request you to go and purchase it, because that will be the first requirement in order to go ahead. And now let's try to understand how do we begin the ISO 27001 implementation. So the first basic step for implementing ISO 27001 that we should go for is to try and understand how exactly the organization works. Now, in order to understand how an organization works and functions, we need to understand some basic steps in terms of organizational awareness. So the step one that comes to my mind is, we should completely understand how the organization functions. And in this step one, there could be an instance where there are some financial transactions involved within that particular organization for which you're trying to helping get the ISO 27001 certification, or there could be some healthcare related matters as well. So that, you know, if you get to know the organization in complete details, then you have to consider taking along with ISO 27001 a couple of more information security standards, which are, I'm not sure if you have heard about HIPAA, HIPAA, and PCI-DSS. So HIPAA is basically for all the healthcare related organizations. So you have to consider HIPAA along with the ISO 27001 if you are trying to implement ISO 27001 for a healthcare organization. Similarly, if you are in a banking firm and you're trying to implement it, for yourself and you're a banking organization, then you have to consider PCI-DSS, because these are the norms for any banking organization in terms of security. So that's what I'm trying to, in the first step, I would like to make, you better understand that, you should be clear about the type of organization that you are dealing with over here, because this organization could be healthcare related, could be finance related. So if it is such a case, then you have to make sure that you have all the other standards which are aligned with ISO 27001. And it is not the ISO 27001 is not the only standard that you are focusing for this particular implementation. So after understanding the organization, the step one, the step two should be, in order to make yourself familiar with the processes. So you have to ask a question, what all processes fall under the scope of ISMS which is there. So you must have a scope of ISMS implementation, so you have to understand all the processes which are falling under that particular scope. So from this particular step, our main objective should be in order to try and understand how information flows in all these processes. What is the incoming flow of information? What is the outgoing flow of information? So you have to understand basically how information flows. That means how information is transferred from processes from point A to point B. You have to understand. So if you will try to understand how these processes function within these organizations, you will basically try to understand the kind of risk that you foresee, because once you understand how a process functions, then you would be able to understand all the risks associated in terms of information security. For example, let's say, are the employees able to get to the public cloud, or are they able to send down some official data to the cloud? Do they have access to the public cloud? Things like that will only be cleared once you are able to understand how exactly the data is flowing within the process. So you have to understand how exactly the data is transferred within the process and how exactly the information is flowing, and what are all the different parties who are having the access to this information. It should be some of your main questions in this step two when you're trying to understand the processes of that particular organization with which you're trying to, you know, get certified for ISO 27001. So after that, the step three should be what all policies and procedures are in place which are already there in that organization in terms of information security. So you have to basically try to understand and find out what are the different policies and procedures which are already there in place within that organization, you know, so that you don't have to duplicate the effort. Let's say the information security policy is already there. So in this case, you don't have to implement the information security policy all over again, because if it is there, there could be a chance that it has not been reviewed or modified for a long time. So you can simply go ahead and edit that particular information security policy. You don't have to, you know, start from the scratch and things like that. Okay. So you have to, in the step three, you have to understand all the policies and procedures which are already in place in terms of information security in that particular organization for which you're trying to get certified. Okay. The step four should be what all are the other policies and procedures apart from information security that are present in the organization. You know, in this particular step four, there could be a lot of n number of things, like what are the different vendor contracts which are there within that organization. Because an organization, let's say, nowadays have tons of vendors. So do they have vendor contracts with all those vendors, and do they have employee handbooks for their employees? So small things like that. So these things again will not fall into the information security bucket, but trust me, they will help you when you will try to further go down the road and you will try to implement the ISO 27001. These different policies and procedures will actually help you down the road, and especially when you will try to implement the Annexure A controls, it will help you to understand which controls you need to implement in order to, you know, control or modify the risk that you have observed during your, you know, observations. So step four is very important. Make sure that you understand all the policies and procedures and all the different vendor contracts which are there within the organization, and you are familiar with them. Only then you'll be able to, you know, sort out which are the controls that should be applied. Then after that, there's step five that comes to my mind after that is understanding the physical infrastructure of the company in terms of information security. For example, how exactly the network layout of the organization is structured, and where exactly is the data center located, and is the data center secured or not, things like that. And when I say understanding the physical infrastructure, this means that we need to understand how the information processing facilities like servers, networks, n number of things are there. So, you know, how are these facilities protected, whether we have firewalls in place, whether we have intrusion prevention systems, intrusion detection systems, n number of things are there. So we basically have to understand how exactly the information is contained within the data center environment in that particular organization for which we are trying to have and achieve the ISO 27001 certification. So after that, last but not the least, after performing all the above steps that I have told you, you should have a clear understanding of the current state of information security in that particular organization where you are able to start the implementation of ISMS. But one important thing to note here is that all your findings and observations should only be restricted to the scope that is defined. I mean, let's say for example, if there are n number of departments within an organization, and from your scope point of view, there's only a couple of departments which you are focusing, then all your focus and all the activities that you are aiming for should be focused to that particular department, not the entire organization. However, on the other hand, if the scope is the entire organization, then all your focus should be on all the things which are somehow affecting the information security of that particular organization. So make sure that while performing these steps, the scope is taken into consideration, because if you will not have the scope in your mind, then this will go in a very vast road, and ultimately it will not be helpful, and you will be having n number of findings but not the ones that you will actually need. So make sure that you have the scope in front of you whenever you will be performing all these steps that I have told you. So that's it for this particular training video. Thanks for watching. This is Luv Johar. If you have any questions or concerns in terms of what I have discussed here, then please feel free to comment below and I will be happy to respond. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because ISO 27001, as I always say, is a very vast topic and there are tons of more videos in this pipeline that I'll be uploading very soon. So if you will subscribe to my channel, then you will be the first one to be able to watch and learn from them. Thank you so much for watching.